Hello everyone, Split Persona here, and welcome to hopefully what is going to be a little bit of a new video series on the channel. We are going to be playing Tiny Tina's Assault on Dragon Keep. That's the DLC for, Borderlands 2. This is Tiny Tina's Wonderland. Sorry. Been a long time since I played Borderlands. But we're going to create a brand new character and we're going to start from the beginning and hopefully go through the story if the videos do good. Me and my friends have started doing actual D&D and I've been enjoying it a lot, and this game, if you know anything about Tiny Tina in Borderlands, she's a very much a bunkers and badasses player, which is based off of D&D. So yeah, we're going to jump in and I'm going to create a new game and we're going to go balanced because that's the normal one. I'm going to go cooperation. Simply because if I end up competing with somebody else, I want them to be able to join me. So, here we go.
There is a world beyond the Borderlands. A world forged by wonder and ruled by fate. The battle between these powers has raged since the beginning. Evil and good. Villains and heroes. A vicious cycle, endlessly repeated. Wonder is the power of a cruel, unpredictable god. But fate, there's one alone who can wield fate. One alone whose story is in their own hands. The Fate Maker.
That's you. Heavy, right? Fate Maker. Big responsibility. Honestly, I wouldn't even blame you if you just laid down in a puddle and gave up.
But if not, if you try and prove yourself as Fate Maker, then heed the warning I give all heroes. Together you fight. Together you shall fall.
Coming for you, Dragon Lord.
Fools. Your party of heroes can't stop me. Already I...
Wow, you guys got here fast.
Like you said, we're the heroes. I am Valentine, gallant adventurer. The scary stabby one is Fred.
What about that one?
That's the newbie. It's their first adventure.
Oh, come on. Their figure isn't even fully painted.
Enough talk. We're here to stop you from taking the soul energy.
Fools! I've already absorbed all of the soul energy. I'm invincible!
Oh, man. Sorry, newbie. You missed the soul energy.
Castles will burn. Babies will cry. More than usual. My skeleton armies will wash over the land.
Looking bad. How do we win this?
We attack together.
Pathetic. Especially you, newbie. They don't make heroes like they used to. Time to die.
But then, just as the heroes lose hope, they hear
a neigh.
Yeah, and also like, you know, like a sparkly rainbow, which goes like quickle, quacka, quacka. It is Queen Buttstack, the most beautiful and perfectest ruler in all the land.
Hold on, what game are we playing here?
We're playing Bunkers and Badasses, baby!
And I, Tiny Tina am the Bunker Master. So what I say goes. And I say there's a magical diamond buying a corn named Butt Stallion who saves the day.
Oh, I was kind of hoping we would save the day.
You will, Valley Girl. I just gotta set the stakes. Now, let's table talk. Cue Dragon Lord!
Butt Stallion, you may be the most beautifulest, perfectest ruler in all the land, but this time, I've won!
But Butt Stallion was wielding the coolest sword in the whole world? The Sword of Souls!
Oh, would you? I just made those skeletons. No! No! I curse you, Valentine! And I curse you, Fret! And most of all, I curse you, newbie! Whatever your name is, I will return and finally rid this world of heroes!
And with that, the Dragon Lord was defeated.
For now.
Exposition complete! Who's ready to riggedy roleplay?
Yeah, might as well. We're stranded here after that mountain totally jumped out at our ship.
Yeah, he crashed it. I'm in. I love bunkers and badasses. I've already got a level 40 character.
No, we are making all new characters. This is the newbie's first game, and I'm gonna make sure it's an adventure they'll never forget.
You ready, newbie?
Time for character sheets, baby!
All right, and we're gonna jump into it. So, as I said, I have played this before. I've actually streamed this with, some of my friends. So we are going to... I've played Graveborn. I have played Spellshot. So we're going to try either Clawbringer, Stabomancy, Blightcaller, Berserker, Spore Warden. Let's go... Let's see. Whenever the Fate Maker applies a status effect, they deal increased elemental damage. Let's try the Blight Caller. And we'll see how it goes. So I'm not gonna go and bore you with, you know, the whole character customization. I'll go through and I'll, you know, finalize everything. And then what I will do is I will bring you back once it's all built and we'll go from there. Okay, so we are back. We are a Blight caster. And I kind of went with this kind of almost swamp feel with him. So... we have a strength of 10, dexterity of 9, int of 10, wisdom of 19, which is very nice, a con of 10, and an attitude of 15. So we are a rogue alchemist. The Royal Alchemist Society strictly regulates transmutation magic. Screw those guys. You made a name for yourself hawking off brand affordable jewelry, but are recently unemployed and on the run after the local baron discovered his new golden amulet was made of chocolate. So, with that said, Split is ready to begin his dungeons, or bunkers and badasses journey.
You've just drawn your own face? over the character sheet?
It said draw your hero, and I'm my own hero.
Okay. And front, it says your starter sword does murder 1,000 damage?
My bad, I left off a zero.
Okay, no plan! Fred and Valentine can't be trusted with pencils, let alone dice. So it is up to you, newbie. You are the Fate Maker. And these fools shall be thine advisors, I guess.
Fine. I advise that you better be a badass. We're here to slay evil and get gold.
I know you see me as a role model. Follow my lead and you'll be a great Fate Maker.
Alright, one last thing. Bunkers and Badasses is a role-playing game, baby. That means you do not break character voice. Kapiski? Break me off a piece of that.
The universe is a garden of arcane mysteries. I will break open its fruit and drink of its knowledge.
Tasty! Now, prepare to enter a world of fantasy!
I don't see anything.
You gotta imagine it, Knucklehead.
Just close your eyes and wonder.
And here we go. Oh, it's been so long since I played.
Heeding the call of the Queen herself.
The Queen herself? What could she want of us?
She fears the Dragon Lord will soon reawaken. You must find his tomb and prevent his resurrection.
What I'm hearing is we get to whoop his ass.
Here's a little cheat sheet to track your health and map and stuff up.
All right. Let's begin this little journey. We're going to run around and we're going to collect as many lootables as possible. So, we got to follow the clopping road. Head down this way and see what we get.
Treacherous bridge! My path is waylaid!
And I love the voice acting. It's so good.
One of the Queen's waystones. It seems to call to you. The Queen's magic enters you through the stone, granting you the power of aura. You now have magical sight and hearing.
Queen Butt Stallion, she's guiding us on our quest.
A fallen tree bars your path. What you gonna do about it, huh?
I cast Identify Tree.
It's a species called Jumpus Tutorialis. And weirdly, it only grows in this one valley. Ahead, the glint of edged steel beckons you forward. Some hot lumberjane has left her axe in a stump.
Alright, Hatchet of Downfalls.
What's that, darling? You thirst for battle? Let's get you a drink!
Of a good axe. Breathing, hacking, even a good old-fashioned chop-chop.
Though the magical hookprints continue through the cave, the rocky ceiling dips low to the ground.
A true fate maker knows when to stand tall and when to crouch.
Yeah, work them sweet glutes. And if you get a running start when you crouch, you'll slide around like a cool action hero.
Apologies if I don't talk much, but there's a lot of narrative in this game, so.
Another waystone guides your path, but reaching it will mean going through a pack of nasty, pinchy crabs.
Yeah! Combat! Kill them all!
Ah! Pinchy! There's no pinchy!
Alright, take out this guy. Oh, he exploded into. Ow! Ow! Back off! Back off! Ow! Gotcha!
You have defeated the crabs! Luckily, they were carrying their life savings for some reason. All yours now!
Alright. Go up here and see what we can see. Continue following hoof prints. Let's see what we can find up here.
A fallen shrine. It seems to
I was but a humble player, like you, Bing Bongs. She has foreseen your arrival and left a powerful weapon for you. The weapon of a Fatemaker.
Alright, let's see which one we get. Thumbsbane.
It's practically ancient, but it shall deal death all the same.
Wait, there's guns in fantasy?
You're in Tainus fantasy, baby!
All right, and we can switch between a four-shot and a two-shot.
For King, you can spy a quaint little village nestled in the bodacious bosom of the valley. Beyond it, a dark and ancient castle lurks. Lurkingly.
My third and seventh eyes can sense the Dragon Lord's presence in that castle from here.
All right. Gotta very quickly reload.
Fate Maker! You will never reach the Dark Master!
Scatty Man Ambush!
Go break some bones, Fate Maker!
And here we go! And take out you, and take out you, and you. And missed you. Got you. Got you. Got you. And got you. Pound.
Uh-oh, a rock slide bars your way to the village.
We're ruined. All is lost.
Very heroic. Tina, can we blow up the rocks?
Sorry, it's impossible. Without explosives!
Victory!
Alrighty.
I never lost hope.
Ahead, you hear the roar of raging fire and the clackety-clackety of bones.
We're here to save the village.
The village is already ransacked and crawling with skilly men.
We're here to avenge the village.
Oh, no, you don't. Get out of here. All right. Definitely need to keep an eye out for a better, better weapon here. But, whoop. Back off you. This little crossbow is not doing too bad. Forgot what it was like to be a level 1 character. Take out the badass. Got him. Level 2. All right. Action skill unlocked. You've unlocked your first action skill. To slot this first skill, press tab and go to the skill menu. All right. We will do that after combat. All right, revive ally.
Thank you for saving my peasant ass, stranger. How can I ever repay you?
I require no payment. I seek to prevent the Dragon Lord's return.
You're a fate maker. I knew the queen would send us a hero. The tomb is in the crypt below Castle Herofast. You must hurry before his minions find it.
The tomb is inside a crypt. The perfect hiding place.
May the Queen's favor see your noble quest through.
Alright, let's see what we can find around here. So what did we get? We're gonna equip this, because that's definitely a better one. And the attack speed on that axe is a little bit better, so we're gonna equip that one as well. Now, time to loot! And I don't mean the bard type. So, let's see, is there any other thing around? Oh! There's these two. Get some gold. Restock on ammo, make sure everything is full. And then we will check out this building over here real quick before we continue. See if there's anything in here. Yep.
Come on, Garifax. You're a powerful wizard who has seen 20 sides of the world. You floated like a leaf upon the Wibblesun winds. You spoke the banishing words at Holgrin's Pass. Just because you've retired to this anonymous village doesn't mean you've lost your magic. If you can just master this ice spell again, maybe the rest will come back too.
Alright, sounds like he's having some issues. But we are going to go and we are going to get our first skill. So, Bog Totem. The Fate Maker summons a Bog Totem companion at target location, which periodically creates elemental bog spirits that seek out nearby enemies, dealing ability damage and exploding on impact. Damage type is based on the Fate Maker's currently equipped gun when activated. Whenever the Fate Maker kills an enemy while Bog Totem is activated, its duration is partially restored. Bog Totem has multiple charges, and pinging an enemy will cause your Bog Totem to target them. Nice. So, yeah, we're just gonna unlock that. And we get one more skill point, it looks like. So, let's see what we have here. We have Wraithmail. Kill skill, a portion of the Fate Maker's maximum ward capacity is restored. That's actually nice. Geist in the Shell. Gun critical hits have a chance to create a homing poisonous bog spirit that seeks out nearby enemies, dealing poison ability damage and exploding on impact. Ooh, that sounds really good. And then we have Virulent. Status effect chance is increased. Status effect duration is increased. I'm liking this Geist in the Shell. So we're going to go with that one. And we're going to leave our hero points for later. But that is going to be... If that's the case, we're going to want to spec into critical hit damage to maximize that as much as possible. But let us continue. All right, let's see what this thing does. Ooh! I'm liking this thing.
That was forever ago. He's a necromancer. It's hard to legit kill him to death. After you guys went bony toe to toe, Queen Butt Stallion locked his butt away in a dusty tomb for a few hundred years.
Oof. He's gonna be a cranky boy.
Ah, so that's how it works. So after it's deployed, I can target another one, and it will automatically change their direction mid-flight. I am very much liking this. Very cool.
Come closer.
Or I can just leave them go, and they will target just about anything in the area. This is very cool. I like this ability. If I were to do a homebrew, something like this would be very cool.
Quite the quagmire you're in.
Yeah, this is a very cool ability. I like these homing skulls. Just set a totem down. Ah, I got exploded. Freezing. Not good. All right. I'm curious to see what other abilities I can get on that. All right, so we're gonna need critical hits, and we're going to need status effects. So, yes. There we go. There's a status effect. And we're just gonna take the other ones into our inventory. Right now. All right. Set this down, and it should convert it over to cryo damage. It does. Ooh. And I can have out more than one totem. Oh, this is going to be very fun. So, let us... get some stuff, and we will continue. Yeah, these totems are going to be very, very cool. So it looks like the skull originates from me if I score a critical hit. Let's pull out our totem. So we're gonna grab the spell book and see what we get.
Oh, magic, my muse! I have it for you.
With the spell book equipped, you can cast the frost spell.
I bet it's extra strong against the undead. They got none of that greasy flesh to keep them warm.
Now, how do we get into the tomb crypt? There's gotta be an entrance around here somewhere.
And down we go.
The bone dry air of the crypt whips past you as you hurtle down into the depths beneath the smells of old stone.
All right, and we found another scroll.
Being a duchess sucks. My servants suck. And prophecies? I spit upon prophecies. That was me spitting. Because they suck. For six generations, my family has clung to this stupid prophecy. The Harrows must guard over these lands, lest a great evil rise again. Well, guess what? These lands suck. I'm getting out of here. One last meal, and I'm moving to the capital. Food's not bad, though. Guards! Fetch! My poison tester! Tell him he sucks!
And that's why you have them test it before you eat it. Alright. Ooh, I forgot about the traps.
You hear a rumble, a booming laugh that seems to come all around you.
Ominous. Feels just like home. I found it! A tomb inside of a crypt! The perfect height!
Alright.
I am coming, my dark master!
He's gonna resurrect the Dragon Lord! That's the exact opposite of what we want! We gotta get in there!
Take out these enemies! I love these totems.
Get out of there.
These totems are so cool.
The Waystone glows. Do you feel its magic within your chest, within your mind, within your soul? It asks a question. Who are you?
I am a fate maker.
You have answered smartly, baby! The carven door to the Dragon Lord's tomb crumbles!
The resurrection ritual has begun!
And the whole reason I came up here was there's a D20 dice that you can hit that will drop a whoopsies! Ooh! Yeah, I almost misadventured right there. But there's a D20 dice that you can hit there. I think I did already get that though on my other character, so. Onwards!
Oh, boss fight! I got a special figurine for this guy. One second. Rising before you is one of the Dragon Lord's most loyal undead soldiers. It's Rivula! Roll for initiative!
Alright. First boss fight! This should go pretty easily. I don't know if my totems have health. I don't think they do. Whoops! Oh, he is almost dead. A few more hits and he's done! Let's seal him up and then we'll come back and check the loot.
The villain in the first quest. Still,
you're stronger than the ones she sent before. I wonder. We'll meet again, Fatemaker. But for now, I have to go pay an old shiny friend a visit. See you around the neighborhood.
Damn it, he got away? We gotta track him down. I want that big bad boss kind of loot.
All right, let's take a look at our inventory and see what type of new stuff we got. So, what did we get as far as a new spell? We got a Guard of Growth and a Guard of Firing. A ward regeneration or maximum ward? Let's go with that one. And let's see what we got here. Concentrated Magic Barrage of Crowds. Simple cast, Fire and Forget, launches two fast, high-damage projectiles. And it is still frost damage, so let's equip that one. And what type of weaponry did we get? We have a much... Is that better than the one we have? Damage is higher, accuracy is a little bit lower, but the magazine is also lower. But everything else seems to be... Yeah, we're going to equip that one. That one definitely looks better. And we have a tattoo unlocked. Nice. We got a customization option. All right, let's continue. And see if we can't... Ooh, there's another chest here. Let's see what we get. Something good. All right, Calamity. Ooh. Guard of Striking returns 24 poison damage if dealt melee damage while warded. That is actually something I am going to equip. Calamity of Flickering. I'm trying to remember. How does That one just fires off those. How does Calamity work? I am trying to remember. Let's equip that and take these. Is this the... Oh, this is the asteroid. That's right. Calamity's the asteroid. Oh, we got a good one.
The Fate Maker's journey begins as so many do, with a heart full of fire and dreams of dragons and magic. It will end only one way, with the ultimate defeat of all evil.
Despite your heroic efforts, the Dragon Lord has escaped!
Wait a minute. Did you hear what he said? Shiny? Friend? Neighborhood? I know where he's headed. He's after Queen Buttstallion!
To warn Queen Buttstallion of the Dragon Lord's escape, you must travel far across the Wonderlands to the capital city of Brightwood.
All right. Let's continue on to Brighthoof. Grandpound. All right. Wonderland's Overworld.
Built you guys this big overworld on the table. Just move your miniature wherever you want to go on it.
Nice detailing on the landscape. Feels like there's a whole world just waiting for us to kill and loot it.
That's right. Welcome to my Wonderlands!
And there it is, Tiny Tina's Wonderlands. Welcome to the overworld. You've entered Tina's living tabletop game board filled with new areas, activities, quests, and dangerous encounters. While on your quest to defeat the Dragon Lord, it's wise to explore everywhere you can. You'll need experience and powerful gear to take on the tougher challenges ahead. You might find your path blocked along the way, but there are friends to be made in the Wonderlands who can aid you on your journey. And that is where we are going to call this episode. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Like I said, Borderlands is always a good one. One of my favorite franchises. And this game in particular has always... I've always loved it. But now that I'm actually playing actual D&D with some of my friends, I wanted to come back and re-explore this game. So yeah, hopefully you guys are gonna stick with me along for the ride, and yeah, hopefully it'll be a fun experience. So thank you guys so much for watching, and if you liked the video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, subscribe, and I will see you all in the next episode. Have a good day.